The neuroscience literature shows us that the human brain by design is creative. We all have millions of different activating neurons and thoughts flying around in our head every day. And when we have two disparate or conflicting thoughts, our brain will bring those together and create some kind of solution and start to problem solve around them. So because it's at this neurological level that we can see creativity happening, we can begin to understand that in fact everyone is creative and capable of creative thought. The other thing that neuroscience is showing us is that it's the unconscious mind that is responsible for creativity. So in your conscious mind, we're able to hold 7 or 8 pieces of information at any given time. But it's in the unconscious mind where creativity really has a seat. And this is for two reasons. The first being that the unconscious mind is vast. It stores a colossal amount of information. And so we have a lot of stuff we can call on in our creative minds at any given time. The other reason is that it is fantastic at problem solving. It loves a good problem. So if you have a problem and you let it settle into your unconscious mind, it'll whir away in the background to come up with a solution. What neuroscience also shows us is that we can cultivate the capacity to be creative. So it's not something we need to sit around and wait for or wonder if we're one of those lucky few that have it or not. It shows us that by using neuroscience techniques and research techniques, we all have a capacity to instantly engage with behaviors that are going to result in a more creative outcome.